ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dreamboat, joined here by Milky with Bro Dogs on camera, and we're bringing you some Prem action for Oz Fortress here. That would be FIFO versus Long Live the Meta. How are you doing, Milky?
I'm good, mate. I'm pretty tired. Had a fairly large weekend. How are you?
I would say something about being tired. I'd like make fun of you for it, because I don't think you can complain. It is currently 4 a.m. Pacific time as I have rolled out of bed to cast the game. So I don't want to hear anything about you being tired, because I'm fired up and ready to go, even though it is 4 a.m.
Yeah, but that was a personal choice. You had every chance to say, no, I'm not going to do that.
Why would I say no? Who can say no when it comes down to casting some Oz Fortress action, especially when we should have a great game on our hands here, like FIFO versus Long Live the Meta?
Yeah, true. Very true. I was speaking to Shifter just before about the game, and I think he's pretty pumped. So if they're pumped, it should be a good one.
I mean, you never can tell. Sometimes teams get pumped. I mean, I got pumped to play against the Yompies in Open, and we promptly got 4-0'd on Viaduct, which included a little bit of spawn camping by them. So that, I mean, you can be fired up to lose, but I think they're fired up because they know that this will be a good game. Unlike any game that involves me playing it. So yeah, look at these two teams here. FIFO, Long Live the Meta. Neither of them will make playoffs, unfortunately. But that means they don't have a lot standing-wise to play for, except for pride. And I don't know about you, but from the talks I've had with a bunch of Aussies, and I mean, me personally, pride means a lot. So I would be ready to go for this game. I would be coming out swinging, ready to win. And I'm thinking they are.
Oh, definitely. Like when there's, you know, when there's nothing to play for, when you're not playing for playoffs or anything, and just playing to, you know, yeah, like I said, playing for pride. Sometimes that can make the best games. Yeah, because everyone's just relaxed. Everyone's just playing the game they want to, and it should be a good one.
Exactly. Just I can think of a famous example of that: Classic Vixup versus the Mighty Ducks. One of the greatest games of all time. Although not if you're a pure sixes enthusiast. If you want the standard meta to live, that's not quite the game you want to go for, but with the teams that we see here, I think we could be in for entertainment no matter how seriously either teams take this.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's probably just going to be a lot of fun. You know, players will probably just want to have fun in the final few games. I assume it's the final few games of the season.
Yep, we are running it out. Playoffs should be soon, if I'm not mistaken. I think this is the last week of the season. There might be one more week. I mean, I'm very uninformed when it comes to some of that stuff, mainly because nobody tells me anything. They're like, lol, you Canadian, you should learn this because Australians know this. And I'm like, oh, okay. Right. Enough about that, though. I think we should look at the rosters for these two teams. Looking over at Long Live the Meta, which features Sam and a Bender on Scout, although I think we have to use a Bender on Scout loosely, as I believe his average this season has been 3 minutes of Scout play.
Seriously?
A little bit more than that. No, it's a little bit more than that, but he has... I casted him earlier this season, which featured him putting a Sentry Gun up on Process 2nd, running Pyro frequently. That was way back at the start of the season, so I can't wait to see how much further he's evolved. But they're the scouts. We got Lambda on Roamer and Campbell on Puck. Ampersand on Medic. And a small change, not that recent. But for those who tuned in when me and Sideshow casted them way back week one, changed their demo. Gone are the days of the Smithsonian 190 DPM demo man and in his tech in his place. Why don't you give us a run?
I remember playing with Bender when he first sort of stepped into the scene, and he still did the same thing then. Yeah, there was a lot of not playing what he was supposed to be playing. So I'm expecting tonight, when he doesn't really have to play for anything, it's probably going to happen as well. But on the other side, we've got, I believe it's TJ and Makassar is going to be playing Scout tonight. Shifter will be playing Soldier. Let me just get up what he sent to me earlier. Makassar's playing instead of Fan, so Makassar will be playing Demo, so it's going to be TJ and Wizard on Scouts, Muppet Medic, MG Pocket, and Shifter on Roma.
Alright, good looking in the roster. And I think a Bender, he's already up to his shenanigans here. We have a Pyro in pregame. And for those who are new to TF2, some people might have shown up here and just been like, what am I watching? What is this? This is Gullywash, this is Sixes, this is Oz Fortress. This will be map one of two. We get to see two full maps tonight. I believe the other one is Granary, if someone could correct me if I'm wrong. Although, that might have been last week. I'm a little out of it on maps here too.
Oh mate, you're talking to the wrong person for that as well.
Oh boy, we are on the ball. It'll be Badlands.
All here, over it.
Actually, is what I'm told. I saw Gullywash off a bat and thought back to just a few nights ago when I was doing camera work on my own personal channel because, well, we didn't run it here. Because we ran into technical difficulties with production, which led to us doing a more casual game. And I saw Gullywash to open things off and I got very scared. But now it is Gully and Badlands, of course. Two of the staple maps of TF2. They've been around forever. Should be in good shape here.
Yeah, Badlands is one of those maps that every team should, in theory, know how to play by now. You know, now, you could probably say the same about Gully, though. Gully's been around for a while.
With teams knowing how to play it, and I'm hearing a little bit of the ready up chirp, so I want to get something quickly from you here. I want numbers. You know what I mean
numbers.
By that?
Oof.
I want Ooh. Predictions.
Jesus, mate. I don't know. As I know the players on Long Live a little better, I'm gonna say 4-2, just for funds.
I'm gonna go with a quick game. Or, I should say, in terms of pace. Give me a 5-4 for FIFO.
Alright. Alright, so we split the bets. Hedged our bets there, that's good. That's a good start.
And now we get into this first bit here as Lambda is going flying in there. He gets taken out early, but he causes a bit of a distraction, allowing for his team to follow up in here. And Campbell is just forcing him to the corner. He picks off MG. Sam taking a fight with Wizard here. He should win this, but a bender went down on the other side. And Sam will actually be taken out with a nice pipe from Mac. Tech takes out Wizard, returning the favor. But Mac gets another pipe onto Tech. Campbell went down as well, and this is a mid-win for the boys on FIFO.
Yeah, I mean, Long Live were pretty good there. They actually managed to get a lot of damage onto Mac early, force him out of the fight, but then they kind of regrouped, used, you know, played as a tight little package, and then when Long Live overextended into them, picked them off one by one. Solid play.
It helps when your demo can just hit two fat pipes and get a couple kills there too. That's always gonna open up a mid a little bit further. Speaking of opening things up, Sam hitting a nice headshot onto Shift of there. As you see a little bit of poking and prodding in River here, and that's bad prodding as a bender and Sam get taken out by Max Pipe and Wizard Scattergun. This prompts that Uber to come right in here. MG gets a little denied on his jump and Wizard's taken out. And this is actually a bad exchange here for FIFO. Mac down. Wizard down. Two down. So
yeah, they got the two early picks, but then kind of beefed the push. You know, they pushed in, didn't really achieve anything, and then had to just kind of back off with their tail between their legs. As a bender is playing Pyro, fantastic.
He is, he's rolling forward with that. And oh my goodness, that was a nice little air shot there from Ship. Unfortunately, he kills himself on Campbell while getting the kill. So, Roamer special there. As we see the product coming down, but these flames are doing a lot of work. And Max actually going to get taken down because he's on fire. Mopat's on fire too. But Wizard is above the point. This could go anywhere. TJ lives on 5 HP. But the second will get capped once again by Long Live the Meta.
Yeah, that was actually... I didn't expect the Pyro to do quite as much work as he did there, but he was, you know, just putting damage out left, right, and center. The ship's trying to come behind the team now, but they should be able to get this mid.
Well, they're rolling forward here. Lambda gets taken out in the Uber pop early here, and there's a Pyro here to just throw a whole wrench into this Uber exchange, because why not? And Tech takes out Shifter with a good sticky, so this is looking very good for Long Live the Meta, who are decimating the meta with their Pyro play. But TJ, Asian Sensation, gets two. MG going down on the other side, and we have a fairly even fight. It is the Med Scout and Soldier versus Demo and Scout. And TJ gets the opening kill there onto the Soldier. Scout and the Medic versus Scout, Medic and Demo, and the Demo's hitting pipes left, right, and center. That's going to force them out of this middle, but they're not going to be able to get any further kills.
Yeah, long live had the better Uber in that situation, but then the players outside of the Uber got picked off pretty quick. So there wasn't, there were, you know, then disadvantaged with players. And TJ was going pretty huge. He's done some solid work for them.
Now the Ubers are coming up here. Long live's getting closer, so they're up. FIFA will get theirs as well, so we'll be leading into an even Uber exchange here once again. But I can't say that that bodes well for FIFA, because if you've looked just at the early Ubers that we've had here, they've been pretty bad for, like, the even Uber exchanges haven't worked out, and long live the meta's actually gained ground. That's how they got off of last. And that's how they're holding second right now.
Yeah, so far the Ubers have been favoring long live the meta. They've played with them better, they've definitely had the better of those exchanges. Whether or not FIFA can kind of look into that and figure out what they're doing wrong, we'll probably decide the next couple points of the map.
Absolutely. And we do see Campbell. He's sitting up in the standard roamer spot right above that door. We're waiting for his opportunity patiently to drop down there and rain death with his rocket. On the other side, we just see a Bender patiently watching Big Door, sitting there fairly past the pole here. And now Shifta walks through. He gets hit with that rocket from Campbell. Campbell might get MG here to shift that down as well. That may not go anywhere on that.
Nah, I think Shifter was just trying to get in, force a pop, maybe take a player with him, but the way that Longlip were holding there, he really didn't have much of a chance to get anything done.
Sam actually came in behind through Big Door, went for a bomb, didn't manage to get anything, and then, well, can't tell. Every so often it looks like, yes, here it is, MG's walking in here, and now the bomb's come right in, and Mac's gonna have to be flashed here. He gets flashed again, and he might get a casualty here. This is really is not a good Uber for FIFA, is MG taken out. Max trying to get back in here, work what he can on the flanks, putting pressure there too. A Bender might get taken out. No, he's gonna live on 6. And we're going to once again stabilize out here. So much for my prediction of a fast-paced game. We're having lengthy around here, just as teams can't work in. And actually, Long Live the Meta are trying to work in here. Could get cut out.
Kind of seems like both teams are just trying to, you know, butt heads with each other and come out on top that way. And it's not really working out for anyone. It keeps resetting to the same situation. So
well,
either
here's
one
the thing.
Team has to
Sam got caught out there, which means that this opens up a little bit of space with the Bender down too. There's no skip. Campbell taking out, and Lambda's so hurt. Tech actually being piped down by Mac too. So this is looking a lot better here, because that's going to be a very easy point for them to grab. They didn't actually drop anybody in that push, and now they're up on Uber. The medic has not come up on his, and he's actually popping right in here. He gets it. 99%. MG takes out Sam, and with that is absolutely brutal.
Yeah, and now that's never down. A good feeling. All right, really? First round.
My lord, 99%, friend. You got a feel for him there.
Oh, yeah, that's rough. You know, you're like, oh, if I'd stayed alive for like half a second longer, it would have been fine, but no.
Well, Lambda actually misses his jump there. He was trying to jump back on the platform, and TJ will take out Sam really early here. Good showing from him. He might grab Campbell as well. But on the other side, Wizard and Mac go down to the Abender Pyro. He ran Pyro to mid, Milky.
Oh, dear lord, man. He's got faith in this class. Tell you what, he's got the medic on fire, though. But that time, yeah, with Lambda not getting his jump off perfectly, that was what kind of helped them out early last mid when they got Mac down. So this time when all their players had health and position, it kind of spelled the end for them. And I don't know if that pyro on mid really worked.
I mean, being as they lost the mid in sort of lopsided fashion, I wouldn't say that it worked too well. Fortunately for them, Ampersand did live, so this time there's not going to be him dying with 99%. If he dies now without popping, it'll be dying with 100% because he does have Uber. Sam is sniping. A Bender, of course, is on Pyro. And that's what we're looking at right now.
Dear. So, like, he's you know, they asked him to play Scout, right? They didn't just ask him to play Pyro and off-class the Scout every now and then, right?
I think with the Bender, you just have to assume that if he's playing on your team, that you asked him to play Pyro. We actually have Uber Exchange here in upper lobby here. Shifta trades out with a Bender. Wizard and MG are actually getting dropped all over the place. Mopat's gonna die here too. TJ still trying to skate out and Mac the other member alive, but they are back on this middle point, which means second's gonna come down from really good Uber exchange there.
Yeah, that was another another good Uber from the Long Live the Meta team. I think that's one thing they're really showing so far is they've just had the better of the Ubers. So every time, you know, the FIFA have tried to push into them with even Ubers.
Sorry, did you see that type from Mac just two piping a scout right up in his grill? Oh. He says, "Sam, no you don't." Types him down. We see Shift is starting to work in here. They actually pick off Limp, but then TJ getting another kill there. So they're two down. They're going to contest this middle with all their might. And they pick off Campbell. So three down. Now with the spawner, Sam still technically two down. That's going to allow them to not only hold mid, but they're going to get into second here fairly, pretty much for free. Wizard is sniping too, which opens things up for last. Shifta right up there in the combo. They get the force off. His ampersand drops down to like no health there. And this is a terrible Uber. They pick off Mac. They got shifted too. But okay, Wizard's gonna get hung out to dry for his team, and everything's falling apart. Mopet doesn't have, so they can't hop in there. Somehow, what looked like a bad Uber, just in terms of positioning where the pop came off, leads into winning second. And now a very bad Uber popped out from Mopet. Here's not gonna get anything.
Yeah, two pretty average Ubers coming out there, but it was the post-Uber play for Long Live the Meta that was a lot better. I mean, Wizard probably hung around too long and just let himself get picked, while the rest of his team were just soaking up damage.
That pop from Mopat, though, was atrocious, and now he's standing here alone. Somehow they win second, and by somehow, I mean by the work of TJ, who's on a 6k right now. Actually managed to pull out second there, and they keep rolling forward. Mac gets ampersand, so that is, like, round save for... Or crown
yeah,
costing,
at least they're not
going
to get last for a little bit. Sorry to talk over you. sorry, mate. At least they're not going to get lost for a little bit now. You know, it saves them a bit of time. They can kind of set up, get ready to a point where they feel comfortable. As TJ's poking his head in and out.
Well, and here's the thing. Mopat is up to 80% here. And he should just be getting ready to walk in here with his team. They're so close. Looking for Wizards in Big Bar. Everybody's with them now. Here's that Uber. And I'm looking for it to come... in through Shutter here. Looks like they want to take TJ. That's what they do. They pop into a, right into the Abender Pyro, but Abender falls down. And we have the Vaccinator coming out here, doing everything they can, and no one has died yet. Finally, Lambda taken out by Wizard, but the Vaccinator Campbell picks off MG. So there's a, kind of a soldier trade there. But now we have the Vax rolling forward here as Campbell's looking for more.
They're trying to push into lobby, and I don't know if this is the right idea. I mean, they only just really held on to last there with the soldier trade, but they're all pretty badly hurt.
Oh, Shifta getting ampersand attack. That changes everything. Mac getting a bender with a trap there, too. Can he fight off Sam? With MG there, he might be able to. And what looked really good and sort of like a miraculous hold there for FIFA, Long Live the Meta, just kind of fell apart because Shifta walked in and said, "Hey, there's your medic, there's your player. Other player, let them just kill both of them." And because he had vaccinated.
They're pretty low after the fight. Fuck, man, we gotta get this synced up. Pretty low after the fight, and Shifter just saw an opportunity and took it, killed a couple players, and ruined the push for them. You know, if Shifter was half a second later or half a second earlier, it would have been, you know, easily gone the other way around.
Well, here's the Uber pop right in here. They take off the NG and the Sentry. There's still a Heavy behind the point. There's still a Vaccinator, but the Heavy goes down. This Medic's getting sawed. Mopat grabbing a nice kill there, and it is just Campbell getting Boston Bashered down by TJ. So that makes it 2-0.
So I got a question for you, Dreamboat. What's TJ's story? I don't really know who he is.
If it's the TJ I know and love, he's an Asian scout and an absolute legend career. And he was actually looking at being one of the Asian guys going to I-58 as we're into this first mid. Well, let's watch TJ. A better actually get taken out by Shift the air shot. Nice play by him there. A few pop-ups, two MG taken out, but TJ cleans up Lambda. He's still doing work here. Mac grabbing Sam with a big pipe, and now he's jumping right in there. Mac jumps way forward, allowing TJ to clean up Campbell. Good little distraction out of him. And the Asian sensation is ruling in with Wizard. They want all of this stuff. As he just jumping in the lower lobby. He's actually coming up behind the medic here. Will he get him? Will he get him? No, he gets spotted up and meat shots him down. Wizard though, still on the medic. Yeah, he gets taken out. Oh no, because of this, with no scout, Mopat could be in trouble. Being pressured in, they're gonna just wisely back off the mid.
Whoop. Are they? They're coming in through Chuck now with the Uber. Oh, big. MG takes out both members of the combo there. Both the scouts from the FIFO team were pretty far forward at the start of that fight, though, with Shifter behind, too.
Here's what you missed. Ampersand had a little crackly sound, and any of us who have played the game for a while know what that means. He dropped! But a really good play from Tech there. He actually managed to pick up Shifter and Mopat, so it's not the most devastating drop.
But it's not that good either. Any drop isn't really a good drop. So...
Well, we actually see pressure on Mac here, even though players are up top. MG grabbing true kills. Okay, TJ, once again, every time there's a threat, he seems to be the guy coming in there getting killed. And I'm lagging. Oh, I'm back. There is a sentry gun. Wizard is trying to 1v1. And TJ gets piped down, so this is not the best start, but Wizard just jumping on the point, baiting everybody in. But it doesn't help if your entire team's dying. So that's not good.
That's not the best way to play.
Shifter, what? How? Okay, Shifter was in secret and somehow managed to pull out two kills there. He only picked off the NG, but he also got the demo. Shifter, I don't know. He's not real. I think he's like a goat. And Mac getting the debt onto camp. He's gonna actually have to stunt everything here, except for the fact where Wizard runs onto a sticky trap.
Than that, Shifter's doing some serious work though. Like, he's finding these little openings, these little positions, and just taking the absolute maximum from it, you know. He's not really getting punished for it either. Like, he's just kind of working his way in. I'm not really sure how. And absolutely trashing on people.
I've got an honest question for you though, with the fact that two scouts there died to traps on Cheddar. Australians know that people put traps on Cheddar. And oh my, MG gets dropped there. The Ubers are exchanged in upper lobby. The pop goes on to Mac to save him, but MG just got a little bit too dinged up, and Wizard! What a shot there, picking up camp. And Ampersand goes down to Shifter. Wizard getting tech too! Incredibly quick scope there. It's and he gets Lambda?
Jesus Christ! Who are you?
Jeez, wow. That's another round for FIFO. That goes solely, I have to say, that goes solely onto the hands of Wizard with those quick little three headshots.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, there wasn't much they could do after that. They lost three players to a sniper who had the team surrounding him as well. So, that was pretty simple, basically. He just killed three players and they won.
And Lambda going for that same bomb again. He managed to jump into something once again. Shifter, though, will be the first casualty on this midfight. Wizard, okay, Wizard gets tech. I thought he was going to die there. But they're all collapsing onto FIFO, who are so hurt, but TJ Summer's still alive. No, he's finally taken out, and with the vendor on the other side, will be the full wipe there out of Long Live the Medic.
Yeah, that was a lot better for them. They managed to keep their scouts alive throughout the whole mid-fire this time. That was something I was noticing on the last couple of mids, is one or both of their scouts would go down pretty early, so when it came time to actually making use of their positioning advantage, they didn't really have the right classes to do so. But this time, you know, they were on top of them, they had the right scouts up, and they just cleaned up.
I need to just pause and stop talking about the game for a second to mention the cutest thing. So I've got like the ground level window here, and my cat is standing outside my window meowing at me because my door is shut, so that like I don't wake up everyone in my house with my casting. And he's just standing here staring at me meowing. I feel so bad.
Why have you betrayed me, Dreamboat?
But he's walking away now, like, so dejected. Oh my god, I'm sorry.
He's gonna remember enough this for the rest of his life. Your cat hates you
about
now.
My cat, but I might, between maps, I'm gonna go let him in and like, give him a hug. Say I love you still, cat. Poor Smudge.
Nah, that's it. You know what cats are like, he hates you forever now. That's it.
He's back! Oh, well. TF2, That's what we're looking at now.
Oh yeah.
But we've got the sentry gun up on last here.
It's gonna be interesting to see what FIFO do on the defense, because we haven't really seen that out of them yet. As they push into lobby with Uber, or they get forced. They got forced. Sorry.
Well, no, they actually pushed in because I don't see the sentry gun anymore. So their scout, they decided they wanted to try and push that.
Shifter getting stuff done though.
He is, absolutely, but he gets taken out once again. That's 2-0. That's working out somehow here. TJ gets another one. Tech so hurt on last, and all it is Lambda. But do they know where Lambda is? He hits TJ. What a shot. If he gets Wizard here. No, Wizard! Living on 4 HP like an actual Wizard.
Yeah, it kind of seems like FIFA don't really want to do defense. They just decided to push out, trade the Ubers, and then clean everyone up. They don't really want to hold. They just want to go forward.
And they're rolling forward indeed. They pick off Campbell. They pick off a Bender. Okay, except Sam getting a nice little body shot on the Wizard. Not quite the med pick he was looking for, but I'm pretty sure he'll take a scout. He might. Maybe.
It's better than nothing.
Oh, he actually takes Mopat with a quick body shot. That's not enough to get the kill. He was looking for more. He wanted more. But speaking of wanting more, it looks like they're rolling in here, but Lambda gets a drop. He drops Mopat and he gets Mac. So the medic and demo use picks there. But Ampersand's so close to dying there, too. Lambda 2. TJ's doing everything he can. He gets rocketed down.
I don't know how Lambda didn't die. He was on, like, one health for 20 minutes.
Oh, my
Lord.
Wizard! Look at Wizard. Oh, he goes for the demo. I thought he might go for the medic there, and I thought that would be incredible. But, you know, it almost worked. They didn't check it, either.
He definitely wanted to go for the medic, but I think the demo turned around and saw him.
Oh, and now that's going to open things up as long as the meta are starting to roll back in here. Moving forward, they actually drop Shift early on. Pop the super, they might grab Mopatu. He's so hurt, and Campbell's the guy chasing him. The last person you'd want. But the frags are coming all around as Lambda's the only one. They have TJ working back here to deal with, and he's being formidable, but I don't think he can go 1v5. But Mopat lives.
Sorry. I mean, you say he can't go 1v5, but could work one day. They're pushing into last now, sort of. A couple of players in, a couple of players still hanging out outside.
Absolutely, Wizard actually taken out once again by Stickies, but Mac and MG trading everything out there, grabbing Sam and a Bender. The Ubers pop off, and they will not find Ampersand, who is miles away. Look, Campbell almost got picked there. You know what that means?
No.
Full Uber ad in the side of Long Live the Meta, getting set to defend the second and then roll into last with it if they don't get four. Campbell jumping in there, might actually get picked off. He will. This is not ideal. But now Sam and Amender getting everything else. TJ gets another kill, but Sam's gonna get popped right in here. He's looking for TJ. He finds TJ. He's looking for whatever he can. He's just gonna stand on the point. He's gonna cap the point.
Well done, Sam. No, that was a much better push. The first time they pushed in, it, you know, felt kind of, you know, like a half effort. There was two players in, one player in water, and then the combo was just out somewhere doing whatever else they wanted. But they, like you said, they kept the Uber up, defended second, and pushed straight back in.
And speaking of pushing in, we are into the next mid fight. I'm actually gonna see what's going on here. There's the bomb from Lambda. He goes for a little bit more passive play, but he gets in there with Campbell. They pick out Shifta because of it. Only casualty so far, the Shifta Lambda trade. Now Wizard will be taken out. MG's all alone. He manages to grab Sam. And now we're into another 3v3. But TJ going deep. He grabs the demo. He grabs. Oh my goodness. He grabs two there. He's looking for more. They're just stuck in this connector. He will be taken out. And this should be a Long Live the Meta win. Unless. Oh my goodness. Mac. Can he actually win this? No. They just popped the Uber off onto Mac. Doing what he can. Now the Uber's popped off the other way, but that's allowed spawns from both teams to get towards this middle area, and we're gonna see a second mid fight, I think. Shift to take it out, and there's so much time for FIFA on mid. They don't want to give this up. Now they're pressured fully out. They have to. But they grab Campbell, though they might not.
That was a strange mid fight. Kind of had two in a row there. But now FIFA, they're holding back on second. It's even players. They have a slight Uber ad as well, which they might want to use.
I can't say I've ever seen an Uber exchange on a mid fight where, like, one team wastes the entire Uber before the next team pops. Then again, I can't see I've ever seen an Uber exchange where it's a demo and a medic versus a scout and a medic. Those usually don't.
They popped into mid though, FIFA. Trying to get some stuff done here, but the long live is still alive. So in all this, the medic should...
He's out, but it's the picks that matter here, as they've grabbed three of them. Lambda, Campbell, and a bender. They almost got Sam there too, but it's gonna be enough for them to get mid, grab some spawns. So it's not a total loss. It just depends what happens here on the meta. Defending the second, and they pop that Uber off here. And they drop shift though, which is fine. I'd take a shift to drop if I was in that situation. Wizard is in lobby too. But I don't think he's gonna get much accomplished. Just distract enough that they can't roll into mid. The other thing we're noting is because of that, we have the leapfrog of Ubers here as Mopat's back in the big ad.
I mean, Wizard kept enough of the team behind that the rest of his team can kind of get up, get ready, and get prepared. And now it kind of looks like they're sort of getting ready to push out in a second.
Well, dropping tech, their demo man's not going to help them. Help the defense, that is. Not when DJ gets launched right into Ampersand and picks him off. So now no heals. They didn't need to really pop this Uber here. Mopat was on full. But they decided to pop it off. Oh, they got a back cap here. Back cap on mid. I don't think the stack can stop it. It can't. They have to go back for it.
That is devastating. That's
what
one of those moments where you're having like the argument in your team, like, do we go back? Do we keep capping? Like, oh. That's painful to watch.
Stack, just stack, stack. No, we can't stack.
Well, if we all stacked it, it would have been fine. Oh, shut up, how do you know this?
I mean, in fairness, it is kind of true. If they'd all stacked that, it would have been fine, but they had to pop the Uber out, so they couldn't actually stack. So that was that was actually a very bad Uber pop from Mopat for that reason. And now, speaking of very bad, DJ and Mac are all dead, as is MG now. Is this push bout is starting to happen? I don't think... Well, Wizard should get Lambda here. Well, maybe not. He should get something? Wiz?
Nah. Oh,
okay.
Not a very good push there. Kind of felt really disorganized.
I was optimistic. That's all. I was just optimistic, okay?
Because it was a good idea. A valiant effort.
But poor execution. And speaking of poor execution, this push into second's not going as planned as Lambda and a Bender die already. MG's right in on this combo for when viewers fade. And he's not actually going to find Ampersand. So that's not quite the way I thought it would go. Now with everyone on the ground, this could go anywhere, but there's the bomb right in, chip that gets taken out. And I'm sort of confused. This really could go anywhere. We might actually have a mid-fight happening on
this
mid.
This is turning into another mid-fight, especially with tech going down now and teams kind of being all over the place.
Well, tech, Lambda, and Campbell while dying should kind of kill this mid-fight immediately, especially if these two scouts, which are looking pretty thirsty, go forward even further. They're going to back off and grab one.
Yeah, TJ and Wizard have been doing a lot of really good work for their team. Especially in these sort of extended mid situations.
Now they're poking and prodding for last. It is even Ubers. But with the way it goes, it looks like Ampersand wants to pop right in here, but he's gonna have to pop to save his demo man. He grabs Shift and TJ with that Uber too. And they defend second. So this is actually very good for Long Live the Meta as they grab MG and Mopat to round it out. Which means as long as Ampersand doesn't die, they still have big Uber advantage. Wizard going forward cannot get the job done.
Yeah, Wizard was kind of stuck around Rock. He went back for a Bender because a Bender pushed straight out onto the second point the second he saw the other team start to push. So I think Wizard was kind of hanging back trying to fight him the whole time and then got caught out when the rest of Bender's team turned up.
I mean, that'll happen. And a nice little trap there from Mac grabbing Campbell. Gonna do a little detriment to this push, not enough though, as unfortunately they're boxed out. There's nowhere they can really defend from. Shift the bombing in, he won't get anything, and the support from his team's not gonna get anything either, and it could actually end up feeding depending what Long Live the Meta decide to do.
Oh, Mac.
Okay, that was dirty.
He can't feel good about that one.
he gets the med with 98%. He gets the demo man, and then his team comes in and gets two more. Wow.
Campbell's real low here as well. He's probably going to go down eventually. A Bender
so
is not
Bender.
Healthy either.
Well, there goes Campbell to a roller. There's the one.
Yeah, that sticky trap, that got him good. That kind of felt good for the meta team.
No, that definitely hurt. Speaking of hurts, Shift is down. And when I say it hurts, I don't mean the other Australian player. I mean the fact that it hurts your chances of winning. And speaking of hurting your chances of winning, long live the metas on Vaccinator, and they're dropping players like Fly.
Well, they don't really have much time, you know, it's a minute 40 left.
Okay,
they're
yeah.
two rounds down. I think it's just a bit of whatever goes at the moment.
I mean, I think it, in theory, is still doable because, well, probably not. Now we're at that it's not doable.
Yeah, not doable.
If they could have just won that fight, they could have capped second and, like, spawn camp last and gotten the cap. At which point it would have actually been doable, because I think you can win a round in a minute 40. But, yeah, now they're trying to take a round for their own pride.
Yeah, it always looks a little better when it's 3-2 compared to 3-1 or 3-0.
Yeah, at least it's not a shutout, right?
Yeah, gotta pad, you know, pad them stats.
I mean, they're definitely padding stats on the side of FIFA right now, is they're just FIFOing all over the place here, or something, and killing people. I don't know where I was going with that. They just absolutely decimated that pushing, getting a 5k, not dropping anybody. So there's your stat.
Yeah, so with 40 seconds left, we can probably just, you know, call the GGs. What'd you think? What'd you think of the first map?
Honestly, I was impressed. I thought it might be a little faster paced there, just because I thought the Abender throws wouldn't quite be as effective. But honestly, I was impressed with both teams. The mids were definitely the strength of FIFA, though, and I hope if that continues on Badlands, with it being a much faster paced map than Gullywalk, we could see a much faster map.
Yeah, well, you know, Badlands whole rounds can just be decided on the mid fight. So if that, you know, if they still have good mids on Badlands, we could just see a pretty quick second map, to be honest.
That's speaking from experience, not, you know, just because one team has good Gullywash mids doesn't necessarily mean their Badlands wins will be good. No, that was not the case with my personal team. We sucked at one and we're great at the other. It can happen. So just because it was, you know, 3-1 dominant mids for FIFA most of the time does not mean Badlands will be the same case. Could go either way.
Yeah, it's hard to say. I mean, the good thing is, like, for FIFA, that their scouts were doing quite a lot of work on mid, and that can help you quite a lot on Badlands as well. So, it could be the case that they are even better at Badlands, but we'll just have to wait and see until we see it happen.
I haven't... we gotta look at that. I was gonna ask if I could go hug my cat, but... No, we gotta look at stats here. Looking at
stats!
Statistics. The statistical analysis that I'm about to bring here is gonna, well, it's not gonna be that much. TJ, that's who we gotta look at. He's got 41 kills, 10 assists, 12 deaths, doing 330 DPM. 4.3k
yeah.
AD, 3.4 KD, that's like, yeah, that's a difference maker right there. I don't think anything else has to be said. Just in general, like, the KD of TJ and Mac were both over 2, which when you have two players doing that much, especially when you consider that Mac on Dem was doing 400 DPM, like, there's definitely the edge to FIFA. The other thing worth noting is the bottom three people in KD are Campbell, Abender, and Lambda, all from Long Live the Meta. Doesn't work out great. Now, the solace for Long Live the Meta is Tech. Because I don't know if you see what I see on Tech. I'm hoping that's, like, not an accurate statistic, because 476 DPM is mental on demo.
That's pretty nuts. To me, that says he was doing all the work for his team.
Yeah, pretty much. The other thing we're noting is we only had one... Oh, no, sorry, we didn't... I was going to say, with Shiftus KD being 1.0 on logs, but 24 and 25, I thought he was the soldier that went positive, but no, he's no soldier for either team went positive in this game. So that's something, too. Soldiers, they're not important class, right?
Yeah, but you got TJ stealing all the frags, so, you know, it's hard.
Yeah. I mean, on the FIFA side, yes, but, man, Campbell... You know, I thought he might have gotten closer to that, but the thing worth noting is it's a 30-minute game, right? The fact that Campbell died 28 times in a 30-minute game is, like, almost a death per minute. Follow that up with a Bender and Lambda both dying 26 times. Like, that's a lot of deaths in a, like, in a very short period of time, because you're averaging, like, one of the, like, essentially three of them died every minute. Every minute, yeah, 20-ish.
I don't know about you, but I find it pretty hard to achieve things when I'm dead.
I mean, how do you think I achieve my 100 DPM? It's because I'm dead. No. I honestly thought you were going to say something. I find it very hard to die that often, but I mean, like, I do that all the time, so.
I was trying to be nice-ish. But, you know, it is genuinely quite hard to, like, you know, do damage, morph out kills and everything when you guys are the ones that are dying. It's pretty simple. You know, at the end of the game, end of the day, the game's pretty simple. If you're alive, chances are you're going to do more than someone who's dead.
Well, and speaking of alive, do you see the other stat I see? Medic deaths. Ampersand died 11 times, Mopat 5. So, yeah, you know, he stayed alive, and he did things. So,
yeah.
There's your difference. The fact that, well, give credit to Ampersand. He technically out-Ubered Mopat. Mopat having 19 Ubers in one drop, but Ampersand having 30 in three drops.
Nothing better than a technical victory.
Technical. I say technical, especially because 16 of those Ubers were vaccinator charges. But, you know, what can I say?
Not much, really. I mean, yeah, I think FIFO just did a better job overall. You know, their mid-fights were a lot better. Having said that, I did just remember that some of their Uber pushes were pretty shaky when it was even Ubers. So there's a lot of things that Long Live the Meta can take away from this game as positives, even if a lot of their KDs and the score were a negative. Good joke, Ed.
Well, I mean, it is definitely hard to have a good Uber exchange when you're pushing into a Pyro, and for whatever reason, you don't expect him to be on Pyro. It looked like that happened.
I don't think you can use that excuse, though, when you're playing an A-Bender team. I think you would probably be more surprised that he wasn't playing Pyro.
True. I don't know. It looked like they weren't, but maybe they just don't know of the Abender gimmicks. Although, maybe. I mean, I think he's renowned on three continents right now, so I think a lot of people know, which means
maybe they're doing that thing where you sort of expect, like, no, surely this time he's not playing Pyro. We'll give him the benefit of the doubt here, but then, nah, there he is.
I got this. Maybe I was misinformed. Maybe we're not casting FIFO. We're casting Fee Throw.
Ooh. That was horrible.
I'm sorry. Oh well. I hear one team readying up. We're down TJ in the server. He's having, I mean, I would say he's having internet problems, but Canada's the one with bad internet, and, like, I thought Asians were supposed to have good internet, so it can't be its internet. He's probably just feeding his cat and hugging his cat like I wish I could do.
Maybe. But the problem with Australian internet and its connection to Asia is sometimes that the routing is really bad. So you get, like, these weird pings to things that are really close to you because you've got to go through a server somewhere in the middle of fuck off nowhere.
Whoa, Milky. It's a family show, dude.
Nah, I don't care.
Oh, okay. Cool. I mean, if you saw the panel that we had a couple days ago, it definitely was not a family show there. That was great.
Yeah, explain these panel things to me. I think I've seen, like, little bits of one, but then I had to go out.
So, basically, they're called the TF Live TV Roundtables. We do them about every 2 weeks. I'm your host, and I got... First one was just me co-hosting with, We actually did it when the stream in-game menu came out. Just kind of as a get to know the TF Live TV people. So we had 7 of us, if I'm not mistaken. Me, Brodogs, Red Hawk, I think. No. Me, Brodogs, Fear, Hobbs, Kaiza, Smith, Fossum, and I think we had someone else. It might have been Red Hawk. I can't remember. Next one was we had Aporia, TJ, and someone else. I'm really blanking on who I hosted these panels with, but Spasonia was my co-host for that. We just kind of looked at what's going on in Australian TF2. And then just a couple days ago, it was me with Fossum as the co-host, and then Red Hawk, Communist, Brutalix, and Jersh We got all four medics from the four playoff teams. And we did kind of a playoff preview thing. That's what they are. But yeah, no, it's fun. Especially when you get Brute there, you know, you're bound to have a little bit of banter.
Brute. What a guy. Team's
but no, it was fun. And speaking of going live, yes. I want predictions before we get into this thing. Give me a number.
I think based off of what I saw last time, I'm probably going to go with 4-1 to FIFO, just because I think their mids were really good, and I think it might carry over to this map.
I was hoping you were going to say long live the meta, so I could call 5-0 FIFO, but, I mean, we'll see. First mid here, Tech throwing out stickies. He's already up on his train, and he's very hurt. Wizard takes him out immediately. Wizard, to me at least, looks like he's playing a PowerPoint presentation right now, going like one frame at a time. Oh, but he gets taken out. Lambda down on the other side. Mac and Campbell trade out here too. So this is once again looking better for FIFO, but the health is not that good on them. The control point is being contested. They will grab the cap though.
They will get the cap. They had better position as well. And taking out oh god, Tech in the first like 2 seconds of mid. That was real good. Like Wizard did so much work there.
Yeah, we're definitely. It looks like we're having a faster-paced game here too, as the push is coming through. They're taking a little bit of spam. They might actually just back off. They are going to back off here.
I mean, Badlands is probably one of the fastest, if not the fastest-paced maps. So I think we're always going to see a quicker game.
Yeah, but for now at least, it looks like things are going to ossify a bit here. As let's see. We might see the overexchange, but more likely we're going to see one of the two roamers try and force something out here. I have to imagine a ship that is sitting in that house area.
I mean, he may be just trying to get one of the scouts to maybe bait someone into him, or he could be maybe looking to try and get a haunter at some point, but he's still just hanging around the house.
Well, actually, long enough, the meta might be looking to do something with this. Campbell's so hurt, and they actually get forced out here. Which is perfect, because as long as Mopat doesn't get forced in a bad spot, they're actually just going to exchange these. I'm not entirely sure how I feel about exchanging here, but it works because MG jumps right in there, lands on Ampersand's head. TJ grabs a bender before being taken out by Tech. And that's going to be second, or at least it should be pretty close down here. Campbell in-house gets spotted out and trapped down, so he's not going to be able to do anything fancy anytime soon.
Yeah, he might try and make a play, because get the medic and give his team as much help as he possibly can. I think I'm lagging. Oh no, we're good.
Yeah, I'm having a PowerPoint presentation. It's called Source TV, as opposed to standard like YouTube video quality Source TV. I'm getting very, very stuttery at times here. Don't know about you.
Yeah, good. It's not just me then. I'm seeing like it's only on a few people, but whatever. We'll crack on. We'll do our best.
Hopefully the stream is fine. If it's not, apologies. It's just the STB. There's not a lot we can do about that. Just as we can't do much about Mac being invisible on my screen.
Well, it could be that you're connecting from Canada and I'm connecting from Sweden. That probably doesn't help.
Oh god, Sweden. You're probably like an Olaf Meister fan or something.
Nah.
TF2, not CSGO. Sentry gun goes down. That was Shifta taking it out. Now the Vaccinator is back up here on this long live the meta hold. And TJ is the only casualty to the Sam Sniper. Mopat runs on the point. He dies. And somehow another terrible last push out of FIFO here. Unless Shifta can miraculously get like a 6k. Well, he gets Tech and then he trades out with Lambda. So not that.
Not the worst. And with his team coming up now as well, it means that the push that we're seeing out of Long Live the Meta could go pretty poorly for them if they're not ready for it.
Indeed,
but so far,
it could.
So good.
Oh, now here comes MG jumping right in there. He does a ton of damage to a Bender. He's gonna live, and they pick off Sam and a Bender, so no scouts. Means that Long Live the Meta is gonna have to try and back up here, but Campbell's gonna get taken out as well. Tech went down to Shift on the other side, and now with Hypes raining in and two people up, Shift is just gonna jump on the point, and he's baited the point well enough, I think, because MG is gonna walk right into the medic and the soldier and captain.
Yeah, very good play. Shift is taking other people behind. You know, and then the re-push coming out from FIFO. Pretty well textbook, you know. Shift made a lot of space for his team though as well, which is something he's been doing across both maps. Is he's just putting in, you know, heaps of work, drawing people back, keeping people occupied.
It was a bit of a bit of a misplay there at two at times. But he did his job. And now they spin fighting here. They're rolling in here. Bombs coming out here. Campbell getting launched back to his choke. And Mopat's actually standing in red choke with a soldier behind him. I don't think he's got to realize it. His team realizes it. As they will get the kill. Wizard going down the other side. Still the only casualties on this mid fight. This is actually looking very good as the Bender picks up two. This could finally be that long run by the time, especially with Tech raining pipes into red choke. It's both that MG standing way behind. Shift the bombs and he gets ampersand. Actually at 96%. Now this is going to give MG the chance to get popped in here. See if he can get anything. I think his main goal of getting something is getting out. And he actually gets Mopat killed because of it. So he did. Okay, they're getting stuff around. Wizard picks up Sam. He picks up Lambda. He's looking for more. Are we going to see another mid fight? We might just do so. Is TJ starting to jump forward here? He's putting pressure, but he should die. He lives. This guy's a wizard.
Ooh.
Teach me how to move, TJ.
Jesus, man. I thought he was dead for sure there.
I mean, we saw another
extended mid fight there. I think that. You know, the scouts at the end, they probably didn't need to be going in like that because they were just risking their life for no reason. As Shifter goes down,
hold on, TJ is jumping around, dodging around there. His dance moves aren't quite as good this time. But man, I just want to go back and talk about how he managed to live on that mid fight. I mean, I know Gangnam Style technically taught us that Asians have great dance moves, but TJ just put on an absolute clinic there on how to dodge spam.
Yeah, I definitely thought he was dead. I kind of wrote him off like, well, scout's gonna die, whatever, and then. You know, next minute, he's in resup, getting health again, coming back into the fight.
I wrote him off about four times in that, so... Power to TJ, the Asian sensation, making work. And, making things happen. But now,
so far, though,
thinking
seeing...
of things happening, we have this Uber popped off here, from Ampersand onto these two scouts. They grab MG. Mac actually picks up Lambda, which is not a huge pick, but still a pick nonetheless. But they get MG, they get Wizard, they get Shift, And Sam grabbing TJ, he's on a roll here. All he needs to do is grab Mac, but the Uber is up. It's gonna actually give time for MG to spawn. And Shift the Wizard and TJ are gonna be close on these spawns. Which means with Mac grabbing Campbell, Mopat dying, there's going to be the last hole. The unfortunate part of that, of course, is Mopat died. And okay, Mac down too. Means that there's no stickies. They have a soldier jumping right on the point. He just blasted to the roof, but he gets a kill. That got capped.
Yep.
Okay.
Unlucky, I guess.
I was really confused because my HUD didn't work. So like it just looked like he got launched to the moon, and then I saw this one soldier running around with his hands up, and I'm like, wait, he only does that if he's capped. But there's like,
wait a minute.
I was very confused because my HUD broke. Get that mid fight. MG getting launched sky high. Speaking of sky high, Lambda going sky high right into. The opposing team, he'll finally be taken up by Mac, but that's way behind enough of a distraction that his team should win this mid. This will be another long live the meta mid. We might see a long live the meta game here with the way they're playing right now. They are on fire.
They've definitely picked it up in between maps.
TJ has something to say about that. He grabs two late. And his team's coming in here. MG grabs one more. TJ grabbing a third. That is a bender. So big plays from TJ to win a mid first team. Just when I said it looked like long the meta, I've started to put something together. TJ comes in there like a Lannister and strikes like a dagger and kills everybody's hopes and dreams.
Well, he got 41 kills last map, so surely he's going for 42, maybe even 50.
Man, when was the last time you saw a 50 bomb in a game of TF2 that wasn't like an hour long?
Yeah, I was going to say, last time I saw that was like a clockwork game. That was obviously they did their halve system. Last time I genuinely saw a 50 bomb.
Hold on. Did you see that? So MG was like walking, he looked at his bank, he's like, med, follow me. And as he turns around, Lambda just, or Campbell, sorry, walked in and then you just put like a direct into Mopat, forcing him, because I mean, when you have a soldier just standing there clicking on you, what else are you gonna do?
But doesn't matter, both scouts stand on the point. Easy job.
So let's go with Badlands. For those of you who don't know Badlands, the point caps, last caps, really freaking fast. And in the blink of an eye, both scouts kind of ran into that lower left area, stepped on the point because there were no stickies on it. They capped it.
That's like an old school strategy.
Oh, it really is. I can think of like many times that like Enigma would do that. But we're into the midfight. Wizard taken out early here. Mopat down too. But Ampersand, they kind of trade medics. But long live the meta once again. Looking in good shape here, especially if they get TJ. They finally do. Tech standing on top of Shift that hits the sticky pipe combination. That's another way. Going the other way. It'll be 2-2.
Yeah, I mean, they took a lot of damage pretty early in that midfight and were kind of forced back into the choke. Initially, I didn't think they were going to win, but then when FIFO kind of collapsed in on them, there was players behind FIFO just taking, you know, doing the exact same damage to them. So, along they kind of came out on top there. But yeah, with the bottom left strat, it's made a bit better these days as well with the Quickie Bomb launcher, where you can clear stickies without having one of your scouts run on, purposefully die, and then the other one caps.
Well, is that actually illegal in Oz Fortress? I know it's illegal in ESEA, but I don't know if it's what your all rule set is on it.
I don't know, I'm playing in Europe.
Well, what we should say is that TJ put enough pressure on there to deny the push, and with Wizard sniping, he peeks into choke, grabs tech, headshots another one, and now they're just getting kills left, right, and center. They grab four of them, Lambda Sam, Ampersand, and a Bender. Just...
Yeah, Campbell got spotted in house as well.
And I cracked.
Campbell could have gone for a play there, but he got spotted pretty quick, cleaned up. We should see them take second off of this as well.
I'm gonna need you to carry this cast because I'm trying to reconnect here to my game craft.
Alright, fair enough. Well, in that case, we've got FIFO pushing on the second. There's some people, some of the live meta players are in the reset just trying to be annoying. They should probably get back there if they know what's good for them. But Wizard's still sniping, so we'll probably try and see them, just wait to see if he can get a pick. Doesn't look like they're holding. No, they're not holding top lobby, so Wizard should be fine to just try and pick off the medic, pick off a soldier, try and shoot whatever he can.
And Pekini will, he's going deep in the right side here. He had a free shot on Lambda, he decides to... He misses it, and he's going to get taken out here too. Mac down as well, but the Uber is popped off, and everybody's dying on... Well, Mopat's finally quickly getting something, but no, he'll be taken out there too.
Man.
That was the Bender getting a kill with the infinite shot, as I like to call it. And he's running at Mopat with it. It's the finish shotgun, because as long as you hit your shots, you will never run out of ammo and never have to reload. You can chain them together and unload, and that's what a Bender's doing with that Widowmaker. He unloads into Mopat and gets the kill. I love it.
It was a real ballsy play for Sam in that...
He's got a sentry gun and he's rolling forward. As I say that, Campbell's popping in here with this vaccinator. TJ's in forward spawns, he's looking for something, but with the bullet resistance, he's not going to be able to find much. He decides to backspawn, and we get this mid, where a Bender has a sentry gun, and long live the meta's running vaccinator. This is impressive.
I remember when these guns didn't exist. It was literally just the real regular guns. Good times.
Well, here's the thing, vaccinator gets popped. In here again, they pick Lambda and Mac trade out this time, and the sentry gun is starting to be built by a Bender. He's got the level one gun up, patrolling the choke point, and now he's setting that up for Troll Spire as his demo man with the paint train is capping away. We're getting set to go into last here because Mopat died again, which means that there is still the big vaccinator advantage inside of long lived meta.
This continuous energy play though kind of makes me want to punch him.
I love it.
Just saying.
He's now setting it up in lower lobby. He might get the level 2 gun up this time. He's working for it. It's still level 1 here. Ah, there we go. We got the level 2. And now with MG and Mopat down, they're just rolling in here. Sam and Campbell go down on the other side, not getting one pipe, two kills. Lambda grabs one here too, and oh my goodness, a Bender goes down with his gun. It is just tech. Check and Ampersand against Wizard, Mac, and TJ. They're just gonna back up here, wait for spawns to come in. We'll see what class of Bender decides. He plays Scout. Soak it in, guys. This is a rarity. A Bender's on Scout.
Interesting choice from a Bender there, off-classing to Scout from his main.
Does he have a main? I think his main is
Yeah, whatever. One of the nine classes.
Now the push-out's coming out here. Mopat and Mac go down. Campbell and Sam the other side, but it's Mopat the medic, which is the crucial pick. I mean, they do only have vaccinator advantage. Not to be confused with back ban. Whenever I say back, just heads up. But Wizard goes down to a Bender. He gets a kill on his off blast of Scout. And now they're gonna get set to roll forward here. They're looking in, they're working forward. They're just putting a Bender right onto the point. A Bender with blast resistance caps it. Because apparently you can cap while vaccinated.
There you go.
That might be my new favorite strategy for pushing Badlands last. Run in with your medic and scout on blast resistance and cap the point. It worked.
I like that. That's neat.
What can I say?
That's real cool.
It worked. Long live the meta. That's for sure.
It's one of those things, you can't call it a stupid idea if it works.
I mean, you can, but then usually you look like a bit of an idiot. So, hats off to you. But Lambda and Ampersand going down immediately. Not the good start to this mid. Wizard kicking out the other way, but there's a lot of cap time on the point. And they grab Mopat, and okay, they grab MG and TJ as well as Tech doing work. Shifter coming in to try and fish things off, but Tech will grab another one. And it's the demo fight. Both
NG
of them
boys.
40 and 28. They both grab their packs. They're coming in here. And I think we have another mid fight. Unless Tech can do all kinds of work. And they're both hitting each other. And I think Tech just won this middle.
That was a much better mid from FIFA, though. They lost the last two mids pretty convincingly. And this time it was right down to just demo v demo. Wizard is hiding under the point. I assume he's going to want to go for a medic pick.
Wizard is a member of the Red Hot Chili Peppers. He's under the bridge. Doesn't ever want to feel like he did that thing. And speaking of not wanting to feel that way, a Bender dies to MG, and now Wizard in behind gets taken out, you know, with no issues there. Campbell bumming forward, tries to grab Mopep, but he surfs on top of Spire. So a nice little surf there for him. Will be enough to keep his life. And they actually have, they're at an uber disadvantage here. So this could be questionable, especially when they drop MG there and are in a giant spam point. Shifter grabs Sam, TJ grabs Tech. It looks like they're somehow gonna grab mid out of this, but a Bender, he's still alive doing work. He gets hit with a good shot from TJ and he's gonna be pistoled down. My lord.
Yeah, kind of interesting that they just sort of threw two soldiers in, lost them, but then cleaned up everyone underneath that. I think TJ got a couple of good kills in there.
I have to say, I've been highly impressed with TJ. He's clearly the best player in the server right now when he's doing tons of work with it. Although a Bender might be better if, you know, a Bender stopped off-classing and played Scout, but I'm not gonna go there.
Well, you know, everyone has their ideas of the way the game should be played, and a Bender involves using ridiculous
Hold
classes.
Hold on. Sam came up right on top of Mopat, hit him with a direct, and actually got the force, and now the exchange is coming out here, and Campbell with the much better Uber is rolling in here. He grabs TJ, looking for more. He's got Wizard and a demo to deal with here. So they're actually gonna lose that exchange. It was a much better pop. They just couldn't go anywhere with it.
Yeah, they popped into the combo and they were kind of locking horns up on the balcony. And there was no one else from their team really around. I didn't really see too many other players. So they didn't really manage to achieve anything with that. You know, they obviously made the other team use their Uber, but that didn't really help them.
Well, Lambda gets taken up by TJ there, then that evens it up with the MG pick, FMG being down. Sam going down here too, and Shift is just walking forward. He gets taken out as well.
So MG's back up, so they still have a small player advantage, and Wizard kind of just went running with it. I don't know what he was doing.
I think they decide that advantages are too meta to use, so they're just throwing them away. A Bender taken out by MG, so that'll actually give them player advantage here shortly, and the Uber actually popped right in here. It's TJ, and they actually get Lambda with this. They might get Sam here too. It depends what TJ can hit. No, TJ will die. Questionable exchange there. I don't really know what they're going for. It's even Ubers, and they bring a solo scout Uber in. But Wizard cleaning sticky, stepping on point. What can Wizard do? He's got everything to deal with, and everything going the way of FIFO, except it's not because Mac is still a god. A devil man, and he's landing types like he's freaking Mario out there. Connects one into the face of Ampersand into Tech 2, and they're rolling back in here because TJ thinks he can get Tech, and he does. He's gonna grab Ampersand, except he feeds a saw. He feeds two saws, and they get Uber.
Oh, that must be depressing.
It's okay, TJ. Blame it on the leg. We accept you as an Asian for not having good ping to Australia, except you have 70 ping, but shh. We'll forgive you for that one.
That had to hurt. Surely he would have got it was in his mind that he would have got that kill, but gives up the two saws, gives him the Uber.
Well, you know, some things, sometimes you just have to be that guy, and I think that's why he's not at the top of Chrome right now, is because of minor issues like that. I'm kidding. We love TJ. He's great, and he actually jumps into a pipe there, but Wizard grabs Lambda, so that makes up for it player-wise once again.
Yeah, and we see Shifta in here. The best series so far. He's kind of been getting picked off. It's just some pretty unlucky stuff.
Yeah, I've got a rumor my team Def, and he just kind of screamed that, like, no matter what happens, like, he's just getting fucked in multiple ways. And that's kind of what's happening to Lamp, as well as to some degree Mopat, as he gets taken out there with the team push. It's just three men up. Shifter was the respawn, but Cap hasn't come down on second, which will give him a chance to get a bit of a defense up. Although they're at about a 40% disadvantage here. And they're just gonna walk towards the point and kill people. So that works too.
Yeah, well, I mean, and whatever works, man. No cheeky stuff this time, no vaccinated plays. They just kind of wiped everyone, pushed everyone back a second, went back to recap it, pushed into last with player advantage.
Player advantage they used quite well there. Just kind of got the frags that they needed and got the cap.
Simple as you get, really.
So now mid-fight's bomb coming really aggressive mid here out of long live the meta. I feel like they feel some urgency to try and win this, and they're getting kills left, right, and center. This is all them except for Shifta and TJ, who are miracle workers, it seems, on these mid-fights coming in late mid, and they get everybody here. Lambda just needs to find TJ. He'll be taking out TJ with a 4K to win that mid.
Damn, son. Huge plays from, long live the meta there at the start, though, to get the medic, and I think it was the demo in like the first 2 seconds of the mid fight. It's just unfortunate, but TJ decided he didn't want to lose and just went ham on him.
Yeah, we might be seeing TJ next set of Akbans or something along those lines with the way that he's playing there. Although, I guess not with that medic whiff early. Sam picking off Wizard with a good little body shot there. That's just a scout pick, nothing too crucial, but that might give Mopat thoughts about how he wants to push this. Obviously, you don't want to walk right into a sniper sight line because, well, at this level, they hit shots. And speaking of hitting shots, he walks into shot, grabs NG. I mean, a little bit too patient. Sometimes you give a sniper that free reign, and they just weren't putting pressure into that choke point. And now Lambda jumping right in there. He grabs Mopat. He actually got the med pick, and now this Vax. It's Vaccinator again, really? But Vaccinator coming out here. TJ runs in, kills Sam. He's on a 6k, still hasn't died from this man, and he's still alive. He's under the point, juking around, dancing. Oh my lord. NG comes in, hits Ampersand, a bender, and pack down as well. Somehow. Vivo, don't want to give this up.
TJ's on like a 7k, and doesn't look like he's going to die anytime soon either.
You say that, but he might. Or not. No, he's gonna kill Campbell. Never mind.
Nine.
He kills Lambda and TJ, please! Like, you should be dead. You should be dead now. Like, no, he wants Sam too. Here comes the 10k. There's the 10k. Ten. TJ, please.
It's been
there's
saving a couple
hurt
a
people. There's the 11k. Here's the demo man. He's gonna get tech here. Oh no, he jumps up. TJ!
He's been their saving grace. I mean, there's a lot of times when they probably should have lost. And he just flat out kills three players.
Blind dead.
Oh.
He gets blind dead.
He's not happy about it either.
Oh, what a way to end that. Getting blind dead. Oh, poor bastard.
That sucks.
We see Long Live trying to defend this point. They get about three more picks there. Shift to MG and Wizard. They haven't picked off Mopat, though. They're trapped. Here comes the jump and the choke. And they grab him. Nice little sticky there from Tech. And he grabs Mac too. Tech saying, TJ, this is my show. I want it. Or TJ running in and killing Ampersand, saying it's still his show. It's a TJ show, everybody. Please change stream name to TJ POV, because that's what we're watching. Doing work. Well, yeah. Shift and Wizard say it's their show, too. They grab a couple picks there, but TJ grabbing his second one. Incoming 10k, I can feel it.
He's got to go for 13 now, surely. But I think overall, this whole map, we've seen a lot better play out of FIFO. They just happen to be, you know, one round behind. But there's six-ish minutes left, so definitely bring this back. They just need, like, you know, solid push in a second, solid push in a last, and then maybe a really good mid-fight.
Well, you know TJ is playing well when he's outpointing his medic.
Mm. Especially when it's a medic like Mopad, who doesn't seem to be dying a huge amount on this map as well.
CJ grabs the third one on attack, he grabs a cap point. He's not done, he wants this game. He's sitting lower right with his scout partner Wizard there too, seeing if they can just run into the point. Sam though, picking off Shift up. Now this Vaccinator push with the Pyro comes in and grabs MG, might get Wizard too, he's very hurt. Matt grabs a Wizard getting healed up here, tank up. Rolling in. This could go either way here.
Long live pushing out into the lobby, and there's not many of the FIFO players around to stop them.
Well, there's Mopat and TJ up on bats, and I think that's really all you need at this point. as TJ's just patrolling it and saying, this is my home. This is my domain. You do not come into my house.
TJ's pretty much been playing out of his mind this time. Not that he didn't play out of his mind in the last map, but it's been a little bit more evident on this one.
Well, the thing worth noting too is there is 4.5 minutes left, although they just popped in here into a level 2 gun and a Vaccinator. They're getting everything around the gun here. They might get kills here too, maybe not. They're really not getting anything as TJ and Wizard are both. MG runs towards the point, he gets picked off with the soldier, but now it's on Mac, Shifta, and Mopat's up, and he gets taken out. And there's the drop of the Vaccinator, and it should be round. It will be 3-3 game, 4 minutes left. This could go any way. And I know who I have to watch on this Spitfire. I know who both you and me are watching. I don't even need to say his name. You know who we're watching. It's TJ Cam.
I'm in third person view, mate.
No, I am too, but I'm going into TJ Cam for the Smith. He jumps up on the point. Pressuring everything, and he's down to... Okay, bye, TJ. I'm glad I picked a good mid to watch. TJ and Wizard, the first two casualties. Lambda kills himself, and MG goes down as well. This is not the best
Shifter,
mid.
Though, gets ampersand.
Oh, he does, grace. Too. Can we see Golden Cap?
Maybe. Unless... I mean, the other option is we see Long Live Cap out and win.
Well, I mean, picking up Sam there is going to be good for the start of this defense out second. Although they drop Demo Man, they can still put some form of a defense. They have that Uber up on Mopat too. So second's not going to be a total loss here right off the bat. Although dropping Wizard, again, doesn't help. And now here comes the bomb. Lambda jumps right up onto the top of Spire. And Mopat's in a rough spot. He has to pop this off here into the Vax. Getting what they can. Campbell goes down. A bender goes Shifta with the flamethrower. He's WM1-ing all over the place. And his team's trying to do what they can. Mopat goes down here. TJ is still left. So is Mac. So this could still come out. But the Vaccinator doing all kinds of work. But what can TJ, Wizard, and Mac do? They're spreading out. They're keeping their space well. They're not taking too much damage. Can
still
they do
a
3v3.
They can still do this. I mean.
Well, here comes their spawns too. Shift is just up in upper lobby. They might actually be able to pull this off. That would be an incredible.
It's still kind of going. They're dragging this one out. I mean, now we got the meta spawners coming in too, so we're sort of back into just a straight up fight.
This is a brawl. It's going to come down to positioning and health. Looks like a little bit better positioning on to FIFO here, but they're dropping players. They just shift in MG. They get the two kills back the other way. But the follow-up, just that much better from Long Live the Meta, as they should grab Spire here. Mopat wisely backing off the last, although he's at about a 40% disadvantage.
This
could
is
spell
really
the
good
end.
For Long Live the Meta as well. There's a minute 20 left. They've got Spire. They can sort of take their time when pushing into second.
Legitimately do or die here. 1 minute. Uber advantage on the side of Long Live the Meta. It comes down to this push. This will make or break the game in this next minute. Well, of course, in this next minute. But it's probably next 30 seconds when this push comes in. Except they're letting Mopat get it. Mopat, he's at 90. They might have whittled away the super advantage. But it's a bender running towards the point and pushing them off with the Vaccinator. They're collapsing on him so hard. They grab the pyre.
What is going on here?
Sam is still here. And his whole team is... They get the skill stick. They get the cap. 40 seconds. Long
wow.
With the meta.
That's
lit the map.
That's well played. That was well done by them. They baited everyone down to the point, especially with the Bender kind of then pushing them back to get as much cap time as possible. Can't say I would have imagined a Pyro push into last going that well.
Well, now it's balls to the walls here, because it's stat padding time. TJ trying to go for that 50 bomb, he gets taken out, and that's going to be the game. What a heartbreaking way to lose.
Oh.
Especially with Campbell standing on mid with heavy, and now he's firing laser beams at Mopat. Insult to injury.
Deary me. What a game. What an interesting game. I mean, personally, I feel like FIFO played better on Badlands, but they ended up losing the map. So there were some pretty costly mistakes for them at times. And they may have lost to, you know, some slightly gimmicky plays out of Long Live the Meta as well.
You know, the gimmicks worked though. And I gotta say, the highlight of this entire has to be that Vaccinator pop on the scout who just stood on point, tanked all the stickies and rockets because it was Vaccinator and Cap.
Oh, dude, that was genius.
Didn't quite work as well with the Pyro, but it still managed to work. So power to... I think a Bender. Fossum has it right in chat. He's the revolutionary mind that this game needs. This is what matchmaking has brought upon us.
Yeah, definitely also, an interesting thinker.
One thing that we didn't give credit to, and I honestly didn't notice, I think it's because of the 11k, why I noticed TJ, is that Sam got 37 kills. He outfragged them. He died two more times, but he put up 367 DPM.
Yeah, he did 2,000 more damage over the course of the map. So Sam had a huge game on Badlands. Well played, mate. Good work.
Well, and a lot of that does come from the impact of snipers. He had those, I mean, they weren't a ton of his kills. He did have 4 headshots, but they were pretty crucial ones. You know, looking back at it, he got a couple quick soldier picks there. And if I'm not mistaken, it was Sam who got a nice little 2K pushing second and last once as well, which kind of won the round.
So. It's also kind of interesting to note that while Sam stepped up on Badlands, Wizard kind of went a little bit missing. You know, he didn't really have the best game. I don't know if that's because Sam was maybe taking him down all the time and stuff like that.
Yeah, it kind of looks as well. I mean, with Shift and MG still not going positive on this map, that really was the difference makers. They just kind of 3 guys go sort of quiet. I mean, they didn't go that quiet when like the average kills was 20, like 21-ish, 22. But you know, Wizard being up 16 and dying 26 times isn't that good. Game lasted 29 times. Two players died 26 times. Like it's hard to win when you have that people dying that often on your team. That said, you have to give Campbell credit. And you know why we have to give Campbell credit?
No.
Over two maps, he's the only soldier to go positive on one of them.
Ah, well done.
He went
mate.
24 and 20. Hats off to Campbell. Yelled it.
He also did a solid job for his team as well. You know, solid damage per minute. So him and Tech and Sam were probably the 3 main reasons that they managed to come away with this map.
Now
and Bender and his interesting way of thinking.
I need some TF2 historians to go out there and find me some statistics. What is the record for Uber charges in a game?
Ooh.
Because if Vaccinator counts in that, Ampersand had 60 charges this game. 6 Ubers, 53 Vaxes, and 1 crits.
Holy
is that
crap.
A record? Is 60 a record? I feel like Bewick might have had more when he played on Bud Squad, but I don't know. That's absolutely insane. Just like that many pop.
That's ridiculous.
It's a pop every 30 seconds.
That's a silly number.
I mean, the Vaccinator isn't, in fact, a silly weapon. Mercy.
You just call me Mercy?
I turned off my overlay. Sorry.
Thanks, mate.
Maybe it's because I want, I'm begging for mercy with how many pops and gimmicks there were in this game.
Yeah, solid save. Good save.
Yeah. But no, that was honestly a really enjoyable game and a really enjoyable cast as well. I had a lot of fun doing it with you.
Yeah.
And I think we should just roll the shout out. So I do want to give a shout out, of course, to you, Milky. Quick question, Milky. Are you 2%, 1%, or skimmed?
No, which one's the best?
2%?
Yeah, there we go. Let's go with that one.
Okay. So definitely want to give a shout out to you. You did a good job as a co-caster. I enjoyed it. And of course, Kaiza on camera because Brodox fell asleep again. No, wait, sorry. We actually have Brodox here this time. Brodox on camera. And yeah, that was a great game. Thanks to everyone who tuned in here. Can't wait to see you guys for playoffs. I believe we have another game later this week, although the date has not been set. It should be, if I'm not mistaken, Ego versus Can't Stump the Trump. Don't quote me on that, but stay tuned. And then playoffs are right around the corner.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to shout out to all the Europeans that are watching. I think I saw Silenti's captain in the chat. My boys. And Jedi Knights, Mumble, if it still exists.
I love Star Wars. Have a great evening, everybody. Drive safe.